What can you tell us about the victim?
What I can tell you about the victim is he was found at Quantico National Cemetery, where we are now.
Is it true that you found stones inside the body?
It is true we found stones in the body.
Oof.
Boy.
Yikes.
Have you been able to identify the victim?
I can't look away.
Yes, we've ID'd the victim.
Why does he repeat everything they say?
Back to the body. Do you know how many stones?
Do I know? What the hell kind of question is that?
What? Today is really not his day.
No, it is not.
We're just trying to get...
Okay, let's just get this out of the way, shall we? Back at the FBI, the press dubbed me the Rambler. So the FBI's PR department coached me to stick to the facts, and, well, that's as good as I got.
Wow, I mean, it used to be worse.
Victim, hit it.
Name is Eric Nielsen, AKA Dozer to his coworkers. Did security work for Vonner Aerodynamics, a Navy contractor.
Jimmy's preliminary exam found that the lungs, kidney, and heart had all been removed.
So what are we thinking? An organ mafia?
No, why pack the body full of stones after you got what you wanted? This seems more symbolic.
Some sort of punishment? Like a cult ritual?
Oh, someone wanted to make sure that his murder was public.
You know, we tried tracing the anonymous tip made to the press, nothing.
Well, whoever made the call either found the body or is the killer. But why would a killer want to draw attention to himself?
Not to himself, to the body.
Well, maybe the stones were some kind of message.
Or a threat. But to whom?
Got Dozer's phone records here. Get this, his last call was to Dr. Grace.
My Grace?
Why would the victim call our Dr. Grace?
I'd better find out.
Yeah, I'll call her.
Night, McGee. Dig into Dozer's background. I'm gonna see what Jimmy's got on those stones.
Don't forget to ask him how many he found. Don't act like you weren't curious.
63 stones, to be exact. I sent them all to Casey for analysis. But I kept one that I thought you should see first.
Creepy.
Right?
Like a human body with some kind of bird head.
I ran a reverse image search through a database, no hits.
Could be a new cult. The way Dozer was murdered, just left on a grave, seems like he was being sacrificed.
Not necessarily.
Ducky. Oh, what a surprise to see you down here.
It's a great surprise.
Thanks for the photograph, but I wanted to see the real thing for myself.
What's the verdict, Doc?
Well, it appears to be an eagle head. The animal-human hybrid has been appropriated by the occult, but symbols such as these have already been in existence long before that. We're familiar with them from mythology.
Right. The Egyptians had the Sphinx.
The Greeks, the centaur.
Then there's Ariel.
Huh?
Little Mermaid. Gives up her fishtail to be a human.
Yes, well, whatever the meaning of this particular symbol, I'm sure we'll find the origin somewhere in history.
Wait, Dr. Mallard, don't you have some friends at the Smithsonian who specialize in symbology?
Yes, I've already called them. They're expecting someone from your team, Agent Parker.
Sounds like a job for Knight.
Actually, I think that you should go with her, Dr. Mallard. Yeah, you know, I mean, they are your friends after all, right? Don't you agree, Agent Parker?
I'm sure that would be helpful.
Very well, then. You know what all that was about?
No clue.
Dr. Palmer and Casey have been trying to get rid of me all morning. They're conspiring to throw me a surprise birthday party.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Hmm?